Every day we are bombarded with piles of assignments, tasks, projects and studies, so and so much that we simply lose the motivation to even start off with them. But at the end of the day, before your deadline, at the dying moments, you simply realize that no matter what, you need to get the tasks done in time. So what stands is that in between wanting to do a task and actually doing slash starting off the task, there is this inevitable, unavoidable friction, which the son of Adam terms to be lack of motivation that keeps you away from your desired goal. Let's talk about how you can simply trick your brain into overcoming this lack of motivation through a simple 5-minute hack. As Instagram founder Kevin Systrom says, if you don't want to do something, make a deal with yourself to do at least 5 minutes of it. After 5 minutes, you'll end up doing the whole thing. This is basically the 5-minute rule in a nutshell for you. The 5-minute rule says that no matter how big or how small the task at hand is, you simply force yourself to do the task for 5 minutes and 5 minutes only. Researchers studying this method have backed this technique up by providing analysis on why people are more likely to succeed with the 5-minute rule. Oftentimes, we start off a task with a certain specified goal. And in most cases, when the task is just too big, the consequence for not being able to accomplish the task seems to keep us away from starting the task itself. This is where the success of the 5-minute rule lies. The 5-minute rule tells you simply that no matter what the outcome is, you simply carry on with the task for 5 minutes and 5 minutes only. This eliminates all sorts of possible fears of consequences, failure, and anxiety. And now, when you have finally gotten up and started off with the task, you have this ghostly momentum that keeps you going with it. As writer and theorist Eliza Yudkowsky wrote, "On a moment-to-moment basis, being in the middle of doing the work is usually less painful than being in the middle of procrastinating." I have always struggled with my Quran recitation daily, and that especially in Ramadan. In Ramadan, what usually happens is that I burn myself out after the first 10 or 12 days, and that was becoming a very big issue for me. I knew I had to solve this thing. So what I did was, I simply forced myself into reciting no less than 10 verses of this alien Middle Eastern language daily instead of 2 or 3 pages. And this task, being easy, short, and simple, made me end up reciting more than just 10 and up to like 40 or 50 verses, and that even daily. It makes me recall a certain point that I learned when I first started listening to this daily podcast from Ali and Taimur Abdal, that inspiration is nothing but a myth that we derive from films and movies where the protagonist comes across this life-changing event or tragedy that influences or allows him to do something miraculous with his life that is flown out throughout the movie. But in real life, that isn't really the case. It is not inspiration that leads you to action, but action that leads you to inspiration. And this inspiration will lead you to consistency, and consistency will lead you to greater success. So here comes the question. So what if I do follow this method and force myself to do something for 5 minutes, and yet after 5 minutes, I don't get the motivation that I wanted to? What do I do? That's a less likely event to happen, but in case it does happen, you see, you still did something. 5% of something is better than actually 0% of nothing. And when you'll go back to that task after a good nap or some good coffee, you'll see that you have an actual progress already made and you don't have to start off from scratch. That's all for today, folks. I hope you found this technique fun and also worth your time. Let me know in the comment sections below if you're gonna try this technique out. And also, don't forget to hit like and subscribe to my channel for more productivity videos. And I will be back again with another video soon next week, inshallah. Till then, adios and salamu alaikum.